Okay, good morning to everyone and welcome to Salesforce Management online classes. This is Dr. Mahesh M. Onjeri, Assistant Professor from Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. Okay. So dear students, I hope you can recall that from Unit 4, we have started chapter number 11 on leadership of Salesforce. Salesforce need to be given a direction in which they need to put their efforts. So leadership plays a crucial role in giving this direction for the sales force or sales representatives. So I'd like to make a share now of the PowerPoint slide. I hope all of you can see the PowerPoint slides.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now a quick recap of what we have discussed in the previous class, leadership of Salesforce. Okay, so why leadership basically is required? Okay, so when the sales reps are hired, okay, they need a direction, okay, so that they can put their efforts into that direction, okay, to achieve the organizational goals. And that direction or vision is provided by the leader of the organization. So here I'd like to remind you again that general manager sales or chief executive officer or managing director or the founder of the organization. So these can be leaders at the top level, but for we are learning about the field sales representatives who work in the field and meet the customers. So most of the time, these top leaders will not be in direct contact with the sales representatives who are working in the field. So the immediate supervisors or managers like area sales managers or regional sales managers can play the role of leader, provided they have those managerial and leadership qualities. Okay, so we defined leadership, then we understood the process, what is the leadership effectiveness and how leadership effectiveness is influenced by personal characteristics, managerial skills, and leadership style of the leader. Okay. So we stopped here. So we were learning about the two leadership styles. One, the transactional leadership, which simply involves supervision of the activities of the field sales representatives, whereas the transformational leadership includes giving a vision, articulating a vision, fostering group goals, and acting as a role model, and providing individualized support to sales representatives. Okay, so after understanding the meaning or these two styles of leadership, we were learning about critical leader behaviors for different situations. So which type of leadership style is suitable under which situations? Okay, so let me remind you that these are the situations, okay, and these are the two leadership styles. So let us go ahead with the first one. Newly hired inexperienced sales representatives. So like most of you also, when you join the job, you will be newly hired and inexperienced, okay. So for such sales reps or under such a situation, transactional leadership style is suitable to inform basic rules to the newly hired sales representatives, as well as to give verbal feedback on their job or activities. So it is more of a supervisory in nature. Okay, so for the newly hired and inexperienced sales reps, it is difficult to articulate a vision and foster group goals, as they will not have any idea about the organization culture and they will not be aware about the leader. Okay, so transformational leader behavior or transformational leadership style is suitable for newly hired sales representatives to provide them as a role model. So they will hear the stories from their colleagues who have joined earlier, or their immediate supervisors like area sales manager or regional sales manager, okay, they may tend to follow the role model. Then individualized support also can be provided by transformational leader, okay, for the newly hired. Okay, then, so veteran rep, okay, low performance due to burnout. So veteran rep is experienced sales representatives who is underperforming because of the burnout. Okay, he is tired or the job is enough for him. So in such a situation, okay, there is no need to inform the basic rules of the company, as the sales rep is already experienced and is aware about the basic rules. Yes, transactional leadership, a leader may provide verbal feedback, okay, to the sales representative that he is underperforming. But definitely in such a situation, as experienced sales representative who is underperforming, okay, who is burnout. So transformational leadership style, okay, is more effective in articulating a vision. So, okay, so the transformational leadership, okay, our leader can talk to the sales representative and provide individualized support, okay, and help him develop a vision for the rest of his career. And this way, the transformational leader can help enable foster the group goals. Okay. Then unstable situation, okay, crisis environment. Say for example, COVID-19, okay, is a ideal example to make you understand what is the meaning of a crisis environment. Okay, the situation is unstable. So during the lockdown, the sales will be no or very little. Okay, when the lockdown is lifted, there will be some sales, okay. So sales will be good only when the complete lockdown is removed, but still customers will hesitate to shop. So this is a highly unstable situation what we are going through now. So under such a highly unstable situation, transactional leadership does not work. It fails to motivate the sales representatives. Okay, only transformational leadership can help motivate the sales representative by enabling them to articulate a vision and providing them a role model whom they can follow and get inspired. Okay, so even transformation leader behavior for fostering group goals and providing individualized support is not useful during unstable situation. I hope you can understand. This is a very good example which I can give you. Then high performing sales representatives, who likes autonomy, who doesn't want to be supervised or ordered. Okay, so a high performing sales representative who does not like to be supervised or who does not like to be ordered, he doesn't want to take or receive orders. Okay, so definitely transactional leadership or supervision will not help in motivating the sales rep. Okay, not the other methods of transformational leadership like fostering group goal, providing a role model or individualized support, but definitely only transformational leader can keep the morale of such a sales rep very high by enabling him or her to articulate a vision for the rest of the career of the sales representative. So this way the transformational leader shows a direction, okay, to the highly performing sales reps, okay, in which they can continue to put their effort and stay highly motivated. Okay, so this is how we can make out the critical leader behaviors for different situations. So a company should know, okay, majority of its sales force are into which situation, 1, 2, 3, or 4. And accordingly, they can adopt a style of leadership. But for this purpose, since leadership is initiated by a individual human, or maybe more than one individuals, okay, so these managers or leaders should be highly adaptable to switch between transactional leadership style as well as transformational leadership style. Okay, so any doubts you have, okay, on this slide, figure 11.2. So remember, the leader should be highly adaptive. He should be able to switch between the styles of leadership, though it may be difficult. But it is not difficult for a transformational leader to switch to a transactional leader, okay, to supervise, simply supervise. But yeah, for a supervisor or for a transactional leader, it will be extremely difficult to switch into the role of a transformational leader. Yes. Any queries on this slide? And there is no sound, at least CR should keep saying yes, no, so that a teacher can understand that students are listening. No queries, right?
Sir.
Okay, yes, thank you. So now I'll take attendance. Yeah. I'll stop the share. Okay, please give your attendance call properly. Okay, Nishad.
Yes, sir.
Aditya.
Present, sir.
Akshata.
Present, sir.
Akshay Pujari.
Present, sir.
Akshay Koradkeri. No, he is not there today. Then Ankita.
Present, sir.
Anusha. Absent. Apeksha.
Yes, sir.
Ashutosh.
Present, sir.
Prasad.
Yes, sir.
Supriya.
Present, sir.
Divya.
Present, sir.
Gautam. Gautam. No. Guru Raj. Guru Raj. No. Then Hanumant Rai.
Yes, sir.
Himaya. Himaya is missing again. Yeah. Kalaya.
Present, sir.
Karthik. No. Manjur. No. Manoj.
Yes, sir.
Meghna Kalburgi.
Present, sir.
Meghna Lokhande. Absent again. Nandan. Absent. Nikita.
Present, sir.
Pradeep.
Yes, sir.
Pramod. Pramod, absent. Pranjali. Pranjali is also absent.
Pramod, present, sir.
Sorry?
Pramod.
Pranjali present, Pramod is also present. Okay. Prashant.
Yes, sir.
Prima.
Sir, present, sir.
Rahul.
Present, sir.
Ram.
Present, sir.
Rohit. Rohit is absent. Varsha.
Present, sir.
Rohit is also present. Yes. Varsha is also present. Samuel.
Yes.
Present. Samuel is present. Okay. Sharan.
Present, sir.
Shruti.
Sir, shall I present, sir?
1 minute, huh? Sharayu, this is a marketing class. Are you a marketing student? Okay, I don't know. After Shruti, absent. Then Shweta, absent. Snehal.
Present, sir.
Yeah, present. Sudarshan.
Yes, sir.
Sudha.
Present, sir.
Suman.
Yes, sir.
Vishal.
Present, sir.
Okay. Anybody who missed the attendance?
Sir, Pranjali.
Pranjali is marked present. Samuel is marked present. And Nikita is marked present. Anybody else other than these three? Okay, so all are present. So let me continue the class then. Okay, so students, can you see the PowerPoint slides?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, now next part deals with the tools and techniques of leadership. So how the leaders, okay, guide and motivate the sales representatives, okay, towards a particular vision of the organization or towards achieving the organizational goals. How they keep the sales force, okay, highly inspired and motivated. So we call them as tool and techniques of leadership. Okay, the best method, okay, to lead is personal contact. Okay, the best method is personal contact. In the presence of a leader, the followers, okay, most of the times definitely feel highly inspired and highly motivated. Okay, so remember, so if you attend a class in the classroom, okay, where the teacher is present in front of you, and an online class. So I hope we can make out the difference. Okay, so how significant personal contact is. So it is because the followers can see their leader, okay, they can listen to him or her directly, and if they have any doubts or clarity, they can clarify it on the spot, okay, and with the gesture and posture of their leader, okay, with the voice articulation of the leader, okay, the followers highly feel motivated in the presence, in his or her presence. So personal contact is the most effective tool of leadership. But as we are learning about field sales representatives, so personal contact is very minimal with the leader. So as I mentioned, okay, leader may be from the top management, like a MD, CEO, or general manager, sales, vice president, sales for that matter, or they might be from the middle levels, like area sales manager, regional sales manager, and so on. Okay. So in case of area sales managers, generally, okay, once in a month or twice in a month, each area sales manager works with his or her subordinates. Okay, the area sales manager goes to the individual territory of the sales representatives who are working under him, and he or she works with the respective sales representatives for 2 to 3 days in a month. Okay, so this is repeated again in next fortnight. So this way the area sales managers can keep in personal contact with their subordinates or their sales representatives. Okay, in fact, one of the reasons for the area sales managers to work with their subordinates in person into their respective territory is to keep that personal contact so that the leadership can be effective. Then sales reports. Okay, so as I mentioned, as a sales representative who is working in the field, okay, they need to generate different types of reports. The one of the sales, such sales report is a daily sales report. So the number of customers the sales representative met, any orders taken, okay, competitor movement, such all such information will be, okay, filled into the daily sales report and sent it to the immediate, okay, reporting authority, generally area sales manager. Okay, so through these reports, the area sales manager can keep track of the performance of his subordinates, that is sales representative, and provide guidance, okay, to those sales reps who are underperforming, and also keep the spirits high of those sales reps who are doing well on the jobs. Okay, these sales reports can provide information about the number of sales calls made in a particular period, day, week, or month. Okay, it can also tell the number of new orders taken. Okay, so that way the area sales managers or leaders can keep updated about the performance of their sales reps through sales reports. Then telecommunications. Okay, so I hope now, I can recall my days as a sales representative. So my first territory was Tumkuru under Protect Labs Private Limited. Okay, so telephone was more popular than mobile phone, though it was there, but it was not affordable by everybody, because I can recall, there were charges on incoming calls. Okay, network was not very good. Okay, like even 4 rupees or 8 rupees per minute on incoming. Okay, and some amount charged on outgoing call as well. So it was not affordable by all. Okay, so I was in Tumkuru and my area sales manager was from Bengaluru. Okay, so, and I didn't even had a landline telephone. And unfortunately, he also did not had a landline telephone at his residence in Bengaluru. So now you can imagine. Okay, so almost there was no communication between me and my area sales manager, almost nil. Okay, and twice in a month, he used to come to Tumkuru to work with me, but how he would inform me? Because most of the time he is planning used to be in the last minute. So he used to send a telegram. Okay, I don't know how many of you are aware about telegram sent through post offices. Okay, so it's like a lightning message. Okay, but many a times, sometimes I used to receive the telegram and I used to get information that and so days the area sales manager is coming. So I used to meet him in the specified hotel. Okay, he used to specify a hotel where I could meet him and the timing. And from there, I used to pick him and work for 2 days, take him into my territory on my job. Okay, so that is how we used to meet. But most of the times I used to receive the telegram late. Okay, so he used to come to Tumkuru, meet both the distributors, and leave on the same day, without my knowledge. Then only during the sales meeting, once in a month, we used to meet in Bengaluru and he used to inform me. Okay, so and so days I came, but I couldn't meet you. Then I used to tell him, show that I used to keep the telegrams, the date written on it, handwritten date when I received it. So that is how things used to go on. But now you can imagine, wherever you are, you cannot escape, from the network of your managers or leaders. Okay, so each one of you will have a mobile phone. And if you don't have a mobile phone, company will provide you a mobile phone and a SIM card. They will pay for the mobile phone expenses. If you can recall, one of the general insurance company compensation plan we reviewed in the previous chapter on compensation. So after all the salary split, below it was mentioned, up to 400 rupees or 450 rupees per month. Okay, mobile phone charges will be reimbursed by the company. Okay, so remember that. And most of the companies will have an app. Most of the companies will have an app, which you need to install in your mobile phone so that they can actually track you where you have been moving. And through the same app, you will be also able to fill your daily sales report and various other reports. So technology has enabled the area sales managers or leaders to keep in touch with their sales representatives on a day-to-day basis, almost 24/7. So these telecommunications, result in better customer and industry information. Can provide selling assistance. In case if the sales rep is in difficulty, he can take assistance or guidance from the leader or area sales manager. Then sales support can also be provided over the telephone. Then reporting responsibilities can be informed to the sales representatives over the phone. If he has not sent any report, he can be immediately reminded. Then other general communication can also happen through telecommunications. Because for leadership to be effective, communication between the leader and the follower is compulsory. Without the communication, there cannot be any leadership, or leadership cannot be effective. Then printed aids. So printed aids can have different subjects, okay, like about the company, about the organization culture, about the products, okay, or about the motivational speeches made by the leaders like MD, CEO or founder of the organization, and these printed aids can be circulated. Now same, okay, instead of printed aid, they can soft copies of the same can be sent to the sales representatives, okay, who can read and keep themselves inspired. Then sales meetings. Yeah, sales meetings are one of the very useful tools and techniques of leadership, where all the sales reps, particularly from a region, okay, assemble together, and all the area sales manager and the regional manager, under the leadership of a regional manager, a meeting can take place. Such meetings can also be attended by zonal manager or general manager sales. Okay, so where the leaders can get to meet the sales representatives of a particular region face to face. So as we have understood, personal contact is the most effective tool and technique of leadership. So here the leaders will get an opportunity to talk to the sales representative face to face. So I can recall, okay, like in Protect Labs, okay, I met the general manager sales, means All India head, only once. Vijay Channa was his name. Okay, so I think he traveled all the way from Bombay then to Bengaluru. So our meeting was held in a 3-star hotel called Atria in Bengaluru. Okay, and he came all the way just to meet the sales representatives of Karnataka region. Karnataka was considered as one region. So we had several area sales managers. I don't remember how many, maybe 8 to 12. Then one regional manager, okay, for Karnataka. Because, okay, there was an important, okay, objective for the general manager sales. The company was planning to launch a new antidepressant medicine called the Venlor. The molecule or medicine was called the Venlafaxine. Okay, and keeping in track the increasing number of psychological disorders and due to the complicated lifestyle, okay, they expected that the demand for antidepressants will rise, okay, dramatically in coming near future, and Venlafaxine being a new molecule will be in high in demand, okay, and that will do very well for the company. Okay, in fact, for the success of Cipla company in India, one medicine is very strategically very important called Asthalin. Asthalin is a medicine used, okay, for the asthma patients. Okay, so Asthalin brand of anti-asthmatic medicine, in fact, turned around the future for, okay, Cipla, and Cipla became second largest pharmaceutical company in India. So this Protect Labs was expecting similar miracle from Venlor, okay, the new brand of antidepressant. They expected that, okay, Venlor brand of medicine will turn around the fortune for Protect Labs Private Limited. That is the reason why the general manager sales traveled all the way from Bombay to Bengaluru to meet the sales representatives of Karnataka region in person, because the personal contact is the most effective tool and technique of leadership. And whole day he was with us, he trained us on the medicine, target market, okay, and the positioning and the way to pitch our presentation, okay, how to take orders. And there is also a sales contest across India, okay, some 10 sales reps, I think, if I can recall, who will take highest order in first 3 months will be sent for a foreign tour, okay. That all was possible only through that sales meeting. So this general manager sales was moving from state to state. Each state was considered as one region. State to state, okay, meeting the sales representative in person and launching the Venlor brand of antidepressant in each region. So that is what we call leadership. Then indirect supervisory aids are also there, where it is very difficult for the leaders to personally meet their sales representative. So what are those indirect supervisory aids? Compensation plans. Definitely a semester 3 HR students can recall how compensation, one of the objectives of the compensation plan is to motivate the sales, keep the sales force motivated. Compensation plan should be aligned, or compensation plan should support the business strategy of the organization. So yes, definitely, compensation plan is an indirect supervisory aid. Then territory, sometimes territories themselves can be motivating. sales quotas, achievable sales quotas can always motivate sales representatives. Then expense accounts. Okay. So all the expense accounts for the month created by the sales rep and sent to the company. Okay, so if they are accepted by the company unquestionably, like it used to happen in Tata AIG, insurance company, okay, where there are no question raised once the sales rep prepares the expense accounts and sent it to the company through his respective branch manager. Okay, the company would reimburse all the expenses without any further query. Okay, so that also keeps the sales force highly motivated. So it is one of the motivational tools and sales analysis procedures. So how the sales of the representative is analyzed. So whether it is the overall sales volume, okay, or is it the gross profit, or is it the number of new accounts acquired, or is it the number of accounts retained? So this way the sales is analyzed in different ways. Okay, so that can also act as an indirect supervisory aid to motivate and control the sales representatives. Okay, so still we have a couple of slides, but I would like to stop here for any discussion if you would like to make. Okay, so two slides we completed, critical leader behaviors for different situations and tools and techniques of leadership. So anything if you have not understood, you can ask me and clarify your doubt in these 6.5 minutes we have. Okay, then if you have want to share something, you are most welcome. About that subject first. Okay, if nothing, you have any information about subject, then general business, general economy, you can share something like that. Yes. And yeah, see, after this meeting, I scheduled another meeting at 9:40. So I will share the meeting ID and password immediately once this meeting ends. So I have to, without wasting further time, you have to join back the meeting. Okay, everybody heard me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now any anything for discussion? Okay, any of your friends or relatives, are they working as a sales representative? Whom you know, friend, relative, neighbor, but whom you talk to, not unknown people, those whom you don't talk. What you could find out is what they're doing in this pandemic. So the number of cases are rising day by day. Okay, and there is a lockdown in Karnataka state. So whatever it is, maybe a medical detailer, for example, or a sales representative of Varun Beverages, Pepsi, or Hindustan Unilever for that matter. So how are they working? How they are working? What are the challenges? How they are being supervised? What about the sales targets? Yes? Anybody? You don't know anybody. Okay. Sharan, you wanted to say something?
Sir, like one of my friend is not into this B2C retailing, sir. Like reps.
He's B2B sales representative. Okay.
Sir, they provide this sir, internet facilities, sir.
Internet facility. Huh.
Yes, sir. To all these this IT companies, sir.
Okay.
So now he told me like they are not into getting new customers because of this pandemic. Because now every IT sector is working from home only, you know, sir.
Correct.
So just focusing on to those customers who have been already their customers, loyal customers. Okay. And they are seeing through that they are not facing any kind of problems.
Okay. So because the strategy is rather than acquiring new customers, retain the existing customers. That is what is the present strategy.
Yes, sir. Because everyone is, every IT company is giving work from home, no, sir?
Correct.
So they are trying to retain their old customers only, sir.
True.
By giving them accounts, new offers.
True.
And even extra high speed internet, sir. Like if it's 50 Mbps, then they are doing it 75 or 80 Mbps.
Okay, correct.
So this, yes, sir. Okay, and they are and they are even planning to like the employees who are working in those companies, sir. No, sir. If they are, it's like if they are Bangaloreans, then they are going to provide internet to their homes, sir. Now, okay. And the company is giving the bills.
Okay, okay. So switching for and then focusing on B2C also then.
Yes, sir.
But actually, company will pay the bills. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Company will pay the bills, sir. Only they will be giving the connections to their homes, sir. Now.
Okay, then it is B2B only. Correct.
YouTube.
Yeah, very good information. Then anybody else? No. Okay. So 2 minutes are remaining. Okay, so what I'll do is I will end the meeting and I'll start the new meeting. Okay, so you immediately join the new meeting. Okay, I'll share the meeting ID and the password now. You can log out and join the new meeting.
Okay.